Die grootste hoeveelheid van die Suid-Afrikaanse jeug wat werk soek, maak in hierdie stadium staat op internetcafés om CV's te tik, uit te druk en dan te probeer by werkgevers uitkry. Lulaway is 'n onderneming wat fokus op doeltreffende toegang tot beskikbare werksgeleenthede vir jong mense. Ek gesels nou met mede-stichter Errol Freeman. Hallo Errol.
Hi.
Errol, Lulaway, what exactly do you guys do?
Okay, so I just heard you talking about internet cafés. That's where we started. You can go to any internet cafe on the continent, you know, on the whole continent of Africa, there's someone in that internet cafe looking for a job. Mm-hmm. They're creating a CV, they're posting it online, and generally that CV goes nowhere. Mm-hmm. So we realized that we needed to have some sort of central database, some sort of central place where that content goes to, mm-hmm. to make work seekers accessible to employers at the end of the day. The biggest problem is access. The biggest problem is most of the work seekers are living outside of the metros, and the majority of the jobs are in the metros, and the best people are not always getting noticed.
Yeah. So if you think about, I'm an employer myself, if I have to go and find these employees, that's often a difficult process. How does the platform for me as an employer make that process easier?
Very much so. I mean, we do have a tech system which basically an employer can go onto and filter according to their needs. We also have quite a sophisticated team behind the scenes, you know, uploading content and ensuring that everything is legitimate and double-checking everything. So, they can go online or they can get hold of us and we can customize something specifically for them.
So, from an employee perspective, often the CVs I would get, the quality of that CV isn't a really good CV. Is there a process to assist the candidates in constructing a better CV?
There certainly is. All our CVs are customized, so they're all, you know, standard. At the end of the day, it's a form that everyone fills out. They go through the whole process with us. They go through assessments, and we photograph them, and we scan all the relevant documentation, upload that onto the system.
Yeah. So traditionally for businesses to find good employees, the placement fee or the placement agencies were incredibly expensive. Do you think that you brought a more cost-effective solution to the market?
Oh, certainly, without a doubt. We're making it so much easier for both employer and employee to connect.
So take us through the challenges that you have. So the platform's been there for a while. Obviously, you're dealing with a big scale issue with all of these CVs coming through. What are the main challenges for this end of the market in terms of, you know, getting a system running?
So when we started, we realized that, you know, tech wasn't so readily available. This was 8 years ago. So we created a job center network. We've got in excess of 250 job centres throughout the country.
Sure.
At most of the, you know, townships, you know, especially the townships around the main metros, where a candidate can come in and go through the process manually. We've also now opened it up on a tech system whereby candidates can actually apply via our USSD platforms, by various other platforms. And we also, you know, we get piles and piles of CVs from various different places and upload those onto our system as well.
So you talking about this uploading of CVs, you worked on a massive digitization process or a project and you digitized 50,000 CVs in Limpopo.
Yes.
What was that project about?
So yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, the province had, someone looking for a job will arrive at a municipal office and drop a CV. Those CVs generally went into a box. Mm-hmm. 50,000 CVs in lots of big boxes suddenly arrived at our office one day, and we had to upload those and put them onto the system to obviously ensure that there's opportunities for those guys that are looking for jobs.
So last year the president launched the Yes Initiative. Just remind us what that initiative was again, and what role you are playing within
Fantastic.
That initiative.
Yeah, so this is it's very interesting, and we're very excited about it. Really, at the end of the day, we've run a lot of internships for various government institutions over the last 8 years, and we find it actually does stimulate and create job opportunities, whereby a business in the past, if they, you know, there's a major hindrance cost-wise and risk-wise, you know, the punitive measures in place with regards to getting rid of staff and taking staff on. So there's a lot of risk, and a lot of businesses don't recruit because of that. If you come to them with some sort of an intern for a 12-month period, and you come with a stipend that the person's salary at least part of it will be taken care of. We've seen a major upturn in people actually taking, creating jobs and taking on new people. Yeah. So the YES initiative is really taking the onus and putting it on corporate. Mm. So it's not only government that are now funding these internships, but corporates as well. Yeah. At the end of the day, the corporates are incentivized for their BE scorecard, but then they actually are creating jobs and job opportunities, and small businesses can get benefit out of it. And young people looking for work can obviously get work experience in a small business and obviously get the benefit as well.
If I'm a small business entrepreneur out there and I say, yes, I want to get these interns into my business, where do I start and how do I get
you go into our website. There's a form that you have to fill out on the website. It's pretty simple. You get there and then we'll get hold of you.
Yeah, awesome. Errol, a fantastic initiative and exactly the end of the economy where we need a lot of help. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Dis lekker om te weet daar is mense wat aanhou hard werk om ons land 'n beter plek te maak. Baie dankie dat jy vanaand ingeskakel het. Ons sien mekaar weer volgende week vir ons maandelikse gesprek oor aandele. Tot dan, mooi bly en goeie nag.